Hello everyone, welcome back to my YouTube channel. In today's video, I'm going to walk you through how to use this Sinking Funds Google Sheets template. This is one of the templates in my digital shop. If you haven't purchased this template, no worries, I'll leave links in the description box so you can go ahead and grab your copy. Now let's get started with the walkthrough video. When you purchase this template, here's what it would look like. The first tab is an information slash instructions tab. And here you'll find my contact information as well as a complete step-by-step guide on how to use this template. The second tab is a custom log, and here's what it looks like when you get it. It's a transactions tab and the dashboard. As you can see, everything is blank, but when you start putting in information in the custom log and in the transactions tab, the dashboard will be activated. All right. We are in the demo copy of this template, and we're going to start with a custom log, and this is the setup tab as well. The first thing you want to do is to select your currency. You can type your currency here, so delete what's there and type your currency, or you can select it from the drop down box. If you cannot find your currency here, go ahead and send me a message and I'll be happy to add your currency to your template. So let's say that you're using the dollar, you can go ahead and select the dollar and the entire template updates to reflect your currency. If you want to change it to the pound, for example, you can see right here that it automatically updates the entire template. The next thing you want to do is to add your bank slash institution. This is where you are depositing your savings or your sinking funds. So I have a few examples here. When you get your template, it would have this placeholder that says bank slash institution. And this is because I use the new built-in tables feature in Google Sheets. All you need to do is click into the cell by double clicking and this disappears, and you can go ahead and type in your own bank or institution. This placeholder text just tells you what needs to go inside that cell. The next step would be to start adding in your sinking funds. So you can see here I have some examples already typed in. If I were to delete this and delete this, you can see we have the placeholder text. Now, when you get your template, it will come with the placeholder text, but like I showed you before, all you need to do is to double click into that cell and type over it. So you type the number here and you type in your sinking fund. Then you will be able to select from the drop down box your bank slash institution because you have already entered it into this area. So go ahead and select it. Here is where you would type in your savings goal. So for the emergency fund, if you want to save $10,000, you type in $10,000 here. Start with your starting balance. If your starting balance is zero, you can type zero here. Type in whatever amount that you need to type in for that specific sinking fund. So let's just change this to $500. Your start date would be the day that you started saving that fund. But if you want to type in the day that you are completed in Steply, that would work as well. So go ahead and select your start dates by double clicking in the cell and selecting the appropriate dates. You do the same for your goal date. So just type in whatever date that you want to complete this savings fund. The next tab is a suggested contribution. And this is based on your savings goal minus the start and the duration between the start date and the goal date. What this is telling you is that if you want to complete this goal by January 2025, you need to contribute $790 every month. The next tab is where you would type in your actual contribution. Now you can use this suggestion as a guide, but in this column is where you type in your actual monthly contribution. The next column, which is months needed, is also automatically calculated. And this is going based on your savings goal, the starting balance, and your monthly contribution. So it's going to take the difference between these two amounts divided by your monthly contribution. And it tells you the actual number of months it would take for you to complete this goal. I added this last column so that you can actually toggle on and off your active and your inactive funds. Or if you want to take a break from saving into that fund, you can actually just select paused. Now, you don't have to use this feature if you want to go ahead and delete the funds completely from the list, or you can use this inactive to change the status. And then you can actually filter by status. You click on this arrow next to status and click on filter column. And then you can clear all and click on active and click OK. You're going to see this pop up that's telling you that you're trying to edit the part of the sheet that shouldn't be changed. If you're only using the filter option, this should be fine. The reason why it's saying this is that within this column, for example, this gray column and this gray column, there are formulas and it's thinking that you might alter this formula. But if you're only using the filter option, this shouldn't be a problem. Go ahead and click on don't show this again for 5 minutes and click on OK. This is okay to do as long as you are using the filter option. If you try to delete one of these cells in the gray area, it will give you that warning and then you will want to click cancel because you don't want to delete the formulas. Okay, so now that you do this, you can see only your active funds show up here. All right, up here tells you the number of sinking funds that you have entered into this table. This amount is your total savings goal, your total starting balance, the average monthly contribution, and the number of active funds. Out of all the funds we've entered, 9 of them or 60% are active. So if I change this to inactive or paused, you can see that this number decreases. The next tab is the transactions tab. And this is the tab you're going to be spending the most time in, meaning that every single time you take an action related to a fund, whether it is depositing money into the fund, withdrawing money from the fund, you would record or log this activity here. So you start with adding your date, selecting the sinking fund. Again, this will automatically show up here after you have completed the custom log. The bank would automatically show up here, so you don't have to type this in, and I'll show you an example of what that is. So let's go ahead and delete these two funds right here. You can see the bank automatically disappears. I'm going to go back here for a second, and I'll show you that the emergency fund is tied to Capital One. Going back here, if I select emergency fund, you can see that Capital One automatically shows, and this just saves you one step, so you don't have to select or type in the bank account. All right, so the next column is the transaction type. And here you just have to select deposit if you're putting funds into the account, and withdrawal if you're removing funds from the account. The next is the amount of money that you are depositing or withdrawing. The way the formulas are built in, you don't have to put in a negative if you are withdrawing funds or a positive if you're depositing funds. The formula has built in to it. So don't add negative 100 when you're withdrawing, just type in the amount as is. It already takes that into account. And of course, the last column is where you added any notes that you want to remember related to that transaction. Right up here, we have a mini dashboard area that you can select whatever sinking fund. So let's say emergency fund, and it shows you the last transaction date. So when this list becomes really long and you want to quickly take a look at the activities related to that fund, all you need to do is select that fund. It shows the last transaction date, the transaction type, whether it was a withdrawal or a deposit, the amount, and any notes related to that transaction. Now, this transactions tab is built similar to the table we saw previously in the custom log. It uses the new Google Tables feature. You can filter it based on whatever column you want. So if you wanted to see all of your emergency funds that you have entered into this table, click on the icon right here, go to filter column, clear all, and select emergency fund, and click OK. And as you can see, we do have two transactions for emergency funds. The one that's showing up here is this one, the one from April 5th, because that is the most recent transaction. The last tab is the actual sinking funds dashboard, and this is where you would go to visualize all of your sinking funds in one place. We'll start with the top area here. This shows you your current balances for all of your sinking funds. The next is your savings goal, just like we saw in the first tab. This section right here tells you the total amount that you've saved based on certain criteria. So if you click on this arrow right here, you can see the total amount you've saved this month, the amount saved per quarter, the amount saved this year, the amount saved last year, and the amount saved all time. And these dates are automatically calculated from the transactions, which is why it's very important to use the correct dates here, because it takes that into consideration. So let's say I change this to August. We are currently in August, so I change this to August, and it's a deposit amount of $500. If I go back to the dashboard and change it to total amount saved this month, you can see that 500 shows up here. So again, it's important to use the transactions tab to log in the correct date so that you should be able to display the amount of money you've saved based on different periods of time. The next is the total amount left to save, and this is based on your goals that you have entered in the custom log tab. And here it shows you the number of funds at 100% goal. So if you look at this entire dashboard real quick, you can see none of the funds are at 100%. Once this circle is completed to 100%, it updates right here and it tells you the number of funds that have fully completed their goal. The next area right here just gives you the sinking fund status. Now, you do have drop downs that would allow you to filter down even further. Right now it says show all, so you see all of your sinking funds here. If we click on this and click on active, it shows you only your active funds. If you want to see your inactive funds, it shows you right here. And if you want to see the funds that you have paused, it shows you right here. And this is taken directly from the custom log area. In addition to this pie chart, the same funds are listed here, so you can see the name of the funds as well as the balance. Let's change this to active funds. You can see that here we have the active funds and the current balances. And then if I change it to show all, it shows you all of the funds that you have entered into this template. Going all the way down here, it shows you some information related to your banks. So remember that each fund is attached to a bank/institution, as well as right here in the bank account. If you go here, it tells you the amount of money that you have in each bank account, just to give you an idea of that as well. And here you have the bank name and the balances in each bank account. Down here, you have your sinking fund summary. Here it gives you all of your sinking funds and the percentage saved. Now, this percentage saved should correspond to what you would see on the graph area. Now, let's move on to the individual graphs for your sinking funds. What you would notice when you purchase this template is that this would be blank, and I'm going to delete it so you see what it would look like. Okay, right now this is completely blank, and the way this works is that you would activate the graph and the table right here by selecting the sinking funds. So this doesn't show up automatically because I want you to be able to select whatever order that you want your sinking funds to display. So let's say you want to see your emergency funds first, select that, and then you can see the balance, the progress that you have made for that fund, and every single information that is tied to that sinking fund shows up here. That way you don't have to necessarily go back to the custom log to view that information. Everything can be viewed right here in the dashboard area. Let's do a few more. So go ahead and click on vacation fund for this, click on home renovation, click on education, and let's click on wedding. Okay, so as you can see, everything populates the way it's supposed to. Now let's take our vacation fund, for example. We have $4,300 left to save. Let's go back to the transactions tab. We're going to add a new transaction to the vacation fund, okay? And let's do deposits. And we're going to add $4,300 because that was the amount that was needed to get to the goal. Now, when we go back to the dashboard area, here's what happens. You see that this now shows up at 100% because we have completed that goal. And now it says funds at goal is 4. And this is because the vacation funds is probably showing up 4 times. So I'm going to go ahead and remove vacation fund wherever it shows up because it just duplicated in the dashboard area. Okay, so I have removed all the vacation funds, and now you can see it truly reflects how many funds that has reached 100% goal. So if you're not going to use all 30 slots that's provided for you, you can go ahead and just delete them. That way you only use the number of slots that is necessary for you. This template comes with 30 different slots, meaning that you can only add 30 funds to this template. And one other thing to note is that vacation fund also shows up here as 100%, as well as it being crossed off because it is completed. That brings me to the end of this tutorial. Like I said before, you can find my contact information here. And if you have not purchased this template, I will leave links in the description box so you can go ahead and grab your copy. Thank you so much for watching.